Good morning, welcome to Life Kids Online. I'm Teacher Jingling.
I'm Teacher John. Let's start our service today with a word of prayer. God, I lift my hands to you. Speak to me and let me know you more today. Help me to see your hands working in me. In Jesus' name, Amen. Now let's have our worship team to lead us in a time of praise and worship.
Travis, we're in the day 16 of the 40 days fasting and prayer. We hope that your fasting journey has been good. Today's prayer points are as follows. Pray that we will always be confident to draw near to the throne of grace so many will receive mercy and grace to help in time of need. Pray that our government ministers in the cabinet will always work with one another and that their teamwork will help solve the problems in our nation. Pray that children of Orang Kuala Duana will love and study and that they will receive higher education in university so they can find better jobs and live a better life. Let's continue to persevere and not fall for the temptations that come our way during our fasting period. Let's also pray without ceasing for our nation. God bless you.
Let's do our part in praying for our nation and fasting for our nation as well. So it's lesson time. We are in the series of Small But Big. And today we're going to learn about Asa from the Old Testament. You can find all about him in 1 Kings chapter 15 verses 9 to 24. Or you can read all about him in 2 Chronicles chapter 14 all the way to 16. But the key verse that I want you to know this morning is Proverbs chapter 4 verses 26 to 27. And it goes like this. Give careful thought to the paths of your feet and be steadfast in all your ways. Do not turn to the right or the left. Keep your foot from evil.
Now who is Asa? Asa was a king from the kingdom of Judah. He had a great ruling up until the latter part of his life. After King Solomon, the Israel was divided into two parts, the northern kingdom and the southern kingdom. The northern kingdom had all the evil rulers, not one of them followed the path of righteousness. This is the same for the southern kingdom, with the exception of a few godly ones. Asa was one of them. Well, for most of his life, King Asa was the son of the evil king Abijah that you can find in 1 Kings chapter 15. And he undid many things that his dad and his evil grandmother did. However, as much as he did his best, he too fell for some repeated mistakes in the end. Despite knowing that King Asa easily swayed away from God, he was considered a godly and good king after all, because he was buried with his fathers in honor.
There are three key points that I want you to know this morning. Number one, run the race well. King Asa destroyed worship idols. He repaired the altar to God, and he even removed his evil grandmother from her position of influence over the land that he reigned. So in spite of his bad upbringing, King Asa did what was good and right in the eyes of his God. Truth, although in the latter part of his life wasn't that good, he did run the race well. So no matter how life gets to us, we cannot grow lazy in our race, but we just keep running for God. Okay? And number two, rely on God only. For all of King Asa's life, he relied on God. But when the northern kingdom, King Baasha, went against King Asa did not rely on God. But instead, he made alliance with Syria. A prophet had come and warned King Asa for not trusting and relying on God. The prophet was then thrown into the prison. So in the end, what happened? King Asa was cursed with a foot disease until his death. This tells us that we cannot rely on others to save us from trouble, especially those who do not know Jesus. And number three, guard against repeated mistakes. All right? Both King Asa's grandmother and father was equally corrupted to the kingdom because they were both equally evil. Growing up in such family must be very tough, don't you think so? Yet when we read King Asa's story, we know that he turned things from bad to good. He stopped evil and created goodness because he relied on God. He did not let his family history serve as an excuse for bad behaviors. Sometimes our close ones make mistakes and we are not allowed, how shall we put it? Sometimes when our close one makes a mistake and we are not to follow them, but instead we are to stop it and guard ourselves from repeating the same mistakes. Children, you got to be very clear in this, okay? There will be people who will make mistakes in our life. There will be people who will come across mistakes, but we got to know what is right in God's eyes and what is wrong in God's eyes. When you find people close to us making mistakes, we got to stop it. And you got to guard yourself from repeating the same mistakes that you come to know of. And to do this, we need Jesus, and we definitely need to rely on God only. Amen?
For family activity moments this week, do check out the craft section of the lesson. We'll be so happy if you did the craft and take a photo of it to show us. We've also included the following questions for you to discuss with your daddy and mommy about today's lesson. The first question is, have you ever encountered a problem that you cannot solve? The second question is, who did you look for help? The third question is, was God involved in your solution? If He was, how?
Hello! This is a special announcement for Life Kids Online. And the first announcement is, number one, August 29th, next week, we're going to have Zoom service! Woohoo! So Baby Church and Children Church will come together for a Zoom service to commemorate Hari Merdeka. That's right, we're going to celebrate together our Independence Day. And in that Zoom service, we're going to have coloring competition. So stay tuned for more information that will come up much later, okay? And the second and last announcements that I want to make today is... Dun-dun-dun! Baby Church and Children Church are finally gonna combine our lessons together. And together, we're gonna bring in more people. We're gonna bring in more things and exciting new things for you. And we'll all start this in the month of September. So get ready for the next 2 weeks because we have two things for you. The first Zoom service on August 29th and emerging video lesson service for Baby Church and Children Church together starting in the month of September. I can't wait for all this with you.
So we've reached the end of our lesson. I hope you've enjoyed today's lesson. Now let's close in a word of prayer. Dear God, You're greater than any problems I face. And through You, help me to shine in Your light so that I may experience hope and joy. In Jesus' name, Amen. That's all for today. Goodbye. See you later at 11:30.
See you at 11:30.